In terms of people, how your subjects respond to that, though, I mean, it's like he didn't seem to waver ever. He seemed to be very happy and comfortable to be in this position. Do you find that different than some of your other subjects in terms of being in that position?
Not really, no. I think it's part of what I do is getting people to talk freely, to feel comfortable in that kind of setting. Let me ask you some questions, because this is an opportunity for me to learn something here. People have said that they felt that I was not hard enough on Rumsfeld. What do you think?
I think actually it was a difficult position to be in, because this is somebody who kept deflecting any kind of responsibility in anything that you presented, and had absolutely no problem looking back at you and with that kind of shark grin and just waiting. So I don't really know what else you could have done. It was somebody who would, I mean, as you said, there was no, as you've kind of said, there's no there. I'm not really sure if there's something that there was more to probe into. Would it be more dramatically satisfying if we saw him crack? But I don't think that's the kind of person that he is.
Yeah, I would read comparisons between this movie and The Fog of War. I prefer this movie for many, many reasons. I think it's a deeper and more interesting film, perhaps because it doesn't give people what they want. People want to take away something redemptive from war. And guess what? There may not be anything. I remember during the early distribution of The Fog of War, people would ask me, well, did you get him to confess? Did you get him to apologize? And I would remind them that I like to think, a nice Jewish boy from Long Island, not a Catholic priest. I'm not particularly interested in hearing confession, but I am interested in capturing something of the personalities of the people that I am profiling. My wife calls McNamara the Flying Dutchman, the man who travels the world looking for redemption and not finding it, tortured. She calls Donald Rumsfeld the Cheshire Cat, the guy who just vanishes and that all that is left is this infernal grin. Or as Lewis Carroll describes it in Through the Looking Glass, that he had never seen a grin without a cat. And in the end, that's what you're left with.